Breaking Doctor Who news. Hot on the heels of Monday's day of filming, Tuesday the 17th of May featured further location filming with David Tennant and Catherine Tate for Doctor Who's upcoming 60th anniversary special. As well as a look into what was being filmed, we also have a surprising detail on who else was present on location. As always with location filming content, this video may contain potential spoilers for upcoming Doctor Who content. As such, watch at your own risk and you have been warned. Alright, let's go, or more aptly, allons-y. Welcome to TARDIS Central, I'm your host Jack and let's get straight into it. Many fans returned to Cyberdog in Camden to see if Bad Wolf Studios would have further location filming near the location of their first day of filming, which was the same place at Cyberdog. And sure enough, cast and crew were back from there early on to set up for another day of interesting filming from the afternoon all through into the early hours of the night. Before we dive into this, if you want to keep up to date on the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at TARDIS Central. You can also follow us on social media for daily updates on the Doctor Who universe. As always, please let us know your thoughts in the comment section below, because if you're talking about Doctor Who, then we want to hear about it. Now, first up, after yesterday's appearance of previous Doctor Who director Rachel Talele and her public denial on Twitter that she wasn't directing any work being undertaken on the episode, Talele was again seen on set, and this time also wearing an official lanyard. So it seems that she hasn't just been making a simple one-day visit to location after all. Though Talele has directed during a Moffat era, if she is back and directing for the 60th, then must make her first time directing for Russell T Davies. Ultimately, Talele would reveal before the end of the day her character as director in the form of tweets that fits the emoji style of previous announcements. Why? Well, we'll come back to that in specifics, because we think someone might have caused this. The next big item for the day is that Yasmin Finney also arrived on location, straight off her announcement as part of the cast for the 60th yesterday, to begin recording her first scenes for the show. Arriving to begin rehearsing her first shots, she also gave a hearty wave to onlooking fans. Take a look on screen now. She wasn't the only one practicing getting in and out of a London taxi, as fans quickly spotted because yes, ladies and gentlemen, variations thereupon, Jacqueline King, who played Donna Noble's mum, Sylvia Noble, all the way back in Series 4. She is back after all these years. So we had Bernard Cribbins as Wilf yesterday and now Sylvia today. You'd be forgiven for thinking your family union was done, but not quite. Actor Carl Collins, who played Donna's fiancé and then husband Sean Temple, was also in the scene. You can sort of see him in the background, but it's kind of small. The three of them getting out of a taxi and comfortably coming together further down the road certainly gives further credibility to the Reddit leak 2 weeks ago. The Finney's character Rose would in fact be Donna and Sean's daughter. We've covered that in a video yesterday, go watch. In this picture on screen, oh look, would that happen to be Rachel Talele being ever so slightly obscured by them whilst also giving them direction for the scene? Until this picture, there had been no visual evidence that Talele had in fact been given any direction. But this picture really got fans thinking, and was likely the reason that Talele made her late night announcement. We just have more film and continue with this scene on screen right now. Now it does feature the TARDIS now set up in a slightly different part of the street, featuring the Doctor and Donna walking over with the rest of the Temple Noble family. A conversation ensues between them all, at the end which is the Temple Noble family then bid farewell to Donna as she entered the TARDIS with the Doctor once more, stepping inside with him and closing the doors whilst the family watched on. Rose and Sean with joy and Sylvia a little bit more concern. This was then followed by filming of the family with the use of flashing light and a wind machine, typically the start of the simulation effect of the TARDIS dematerialization for reaction shots. Okay, so next, as we told you earlier in the week, David Tennant was spotted walking around on location on Monday, wearing what looked to be very close to his 10th Doctor outfit. Since then, Tuesday's filming has shown that the trousers and jacket feature a different patterning from his old style, being rather more played. So it's not just the dark overcoat that's changed for the Doctor's wardrobe. Has Tennant taken on a new look? Or is there something more to the Doctor that Tennant is playing for the 60th anniversary? Also, we've got to share this. In terms of notable production staff, the man, the myth, the legend, Russell T Davies was spotted coming on the set to see how things were proceeding. He also shared a quick wave to fans and said hello to some of them because it's just Russell and he's amazing. Another producer, Phil Coniston, has also been seen too, potentially taking some photos of the onlooking crowd. After a long hard day at work, Tennant and Tate left location around 8 p.m, sharing a quick wave to some of the cast watching by and also the fans on set as well. Lastly, some eagle-eyed fans on location spotted art decoration posters put up by the crew for filming, as well as a poster cheekily referencing Henrik's, the shop chain that featured in Russell T Davies' first Doctor Who story, Rose, way back in 2005. This was Rose's workplace. Some of the posts established that London is also a setting of scenes too, and there are upcoming events in the area in October and December, suggesting the story likely takes place during the autumn time. And of course, the big question is how scenes were filmed on this day, connected with filmed on a Monday, which we now have a slightly better footage of. Take a look on screen. It does seem London is most definitely under threat again, and I'm all excited for it. Now additionally, we don't have quite as much footage of this, but there was some scenes surrounded around which looked like production staff being talking into cameras. Could we be seeing a new Doctor Who Confidential type of show in the works? That would certainly be amazing, and for those who remember the old good old days, Doctor Who Confidential was certainly a very interesting show and very fun for those of us who loved our behind the scenes. Certainly in modern media with the likes of streaming shows such as Star Trek and Halo, and also Star Wars, we're getting a lot of these after action shows at the minute, which interview the cast and crew and give a little hint of what's coming up on the next week. Doctor Who could definitely do something like that again, and if they are filming with Doctor Who Confidential, that is going to be amazing. Okay, so small disclaimer, in the interest of fairness, all our sources are linked in the video description below. As a reminder, until the BBC and Bad Wolf confirm things, everything should be taken with a pinch of salt right now. Additionally, we should keep in mind that Russell T. Davies is known to throw red herrings out, and has admitted in such recent weeks they are actively doing so, so perhaps not everything that was seen will be quite trustworthy. Well, what a week it's been so far. Quite an interesting return to filming for all those involved. It'll certainly be quite exciting to see how things pan out from here, and what might come from further filming later down the road. In the meantime, if you want to keep up to date on all the latest Doctor Who news, lore and more, then make sure to hit that subscribe button to never miss a video from the team here at Tardis Central. You can also follow us on social media, but now I've been Jack, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.